I'm gonna eat it all. In fact, it's delicious, very, very good. I never ever thought that I'm gonna mix salty and sweet things in one dish, but it's perfect.
I like these old fisherman's shacks. And the boat. This island is so diversified. You can see everything. See now this? Like a small forest. Green and houses, still the coast. This is the island of Blue Virgin. The name is Blue Virgin. And the legend said that the witches go over there to connect with the devil. Another one interesting spot here.
Now, this interesting rock formations here. See? They're like labyrinths here, like tunnels. Digged from the sea, from the ocean. Many more here.
I already saw so many interesting places only on this island. Very good. I think that this color is the favorite color to almost every person in Sweden. It's like a dark red or something like that, like roof tile color. Almost every building is painted this way. Oh shit, every part of the island is different. I was wondering when we are going to see lighthouse, and here you go, the lighthouse is there. Beautiful spot. See the swans? Lighthouse, yeah. They said that we can't go here with the bikes. I saw that sign, but anyway. I got really confused, but now we are on the north part of the island, which is mean now we go back south and then take the bridge right and go into the mainland. Beautiful lake here, beautiful. actually is very nice track to stretch my legs a bit through the forest. Wonderful. There are a lot of blueberries here. So we made a really nice loop on this island. And after a few minutes we're gonna take the bridge. And from there we'll head back to Luni's place. So we've got around 200 kilometers more to cover. And it will be mostly highways because it's already 3 o'clock. But anyway, I enjoyed the day very, very much.
First, I want to show you what we're gonna eat now. For Lunis, which is my host, it's easy because it's from here, from Sweden. But for me, it's something absolutely new. So what exactly it is, my friend? Potato with?
It's pork inside.
Pork inside with
specific spices.
Okay.
It's called kapkake for the cakes.
And we add some cream and some berries here. All right, let's try it now. I'm gonna eat it all. In fact, it's delicious. Very, very good. I never even thought that I'm gonna mix salty and sweet things in one dish, but it's perfect.
Oh man, this was absolutely delicious. As I said, I never thought that I'm gonna like this combination, but it was perfect. So what we're gonna do now, we'll check here the nearby KTM shop. I would like to buy oil, to change my oil again, because I've got 8,000 kilometers more since I changed it last time in Sofia, Bulgaria. So it will be nice if I'm able to change it once again. Beautiful spot. Day from 9 o'clock in the morning until the 8 of the evening. Well, I've done how many? 550 kilometers. I saw a big part of Sweden, so it was really, really good day. And now with this sunset, I will over this episode. Good morning. It is 6 o'clock. I woke up so early, 5 o'clock, and I plan to start at 7. But because I have nothing to do now, I decided to go early. So I have my GPS set because I need to be at the port of Sweden, Trelleborg, at maximum 8 o'clock. So I don't want any mistakes. I'll use the GPS to guide me out of the town, out of this village, and then I'll get the main road. And of course I don't want to wake up anyone, so I'll push the bike until there and start it there because it's so early. So I said goodbye to my friend last night, so it's alright. I'm not going to upset them because I left early, so this is the plan for now. Okay, go my just itinerary, go. I should be reached the port after 1 hour and 20-30 minutes. I'm gonna have breakfast there and wait. It is 12 degrees, a bit chilly, but I'm well dressed. I'm gonna survive. Okay, I'm in Trelleborg. It was really cold ride. Now it's 14 degrees, but in the last 30 minutes I was shivering. I don't want to stop and take more clothes because I know that on the boat it's going to be warm. But anyway, I'm here. Just need to find the ship. Very, very close. Let me check how the system works. Alright, it was a bit complicated, but I have my boarding pass. Let me show you what you have to do. So, on this machine, you have to choose your language and then add your reservation number and it will print your ticket. But as I said, it was a little bit complicated to do what you have to do. But anyway, I've done it and now I have to wait. No, I don't need to wait. I need to go with my ticket, I think, I guess. Yes, exactly. On the ticket you have terminal, so I have terminal E and follow the signs. Terminal E is here. Terminal E, lane number 150. This is what it said. Terminal E and F into the right. Yeah guys, as I said, it's a bit complicated, but if you follow the signs, it's all good. Terminal E, say it on. Terminal F is your turn. You need terminal E, so go say it on. Okay, so I need the ticket once again. Okay. Open. And then was line 150. Line 150. I told you that I came here to take the ferry, but I did not tell you why. Why I did not continue to Norway. Instead of that, I took this way. Because after I checked the conditions and the situation, and I checked every possible source that I found, and I realized that my journey to Norway, it's not going to happen. There are a few reasons. The first, of course, is coronavirus. It's, the borders are closed. The information from Norwegian side is that every person who is coming into the country from the red zones, which I belong, need to stay in 10 days quarantine. Include my country Bulgaria, include Sweden, the part I came, include Poland. The only possible way for me will be to go back to Germany and from Germany take a ferry to Norway. And maybe then they might let me go in without quarantine, but it is not guaranteed because I am still Bulgarian citizen and I was in Bulgaria in the last few months. So this is still questionable. So instead of going more 1,000 kilometers up and come back without anything, I decided to come here. And the second reason is because now it's already end of August, so until I get to the top it will be the beginning of September, and it might be very, very cold. I checked the forecast, and the forecast said that in the next 10 days it's going to be, in the north part of Norway, it's going to be 10 degrees and below and rain every single day. So it's not going to be fun. I won't be able to film anything. That's why I decided, forget about it. It will be another trip, another year. And that's it. So from here now I'm gonna take the ferry and go straight on to Germany. Finally, we go in with already 30 minutes delay. And until the ship start will be at least more 30, because we still did not load. And many more trucks, whatever.
Just arrived in Rostock. This actually is Warnemünde. And this is the hotel part, sightseeing boats. The ride was around almost 6 hours, but we are finally here. Warnemünde actually is a small resort town located on the North Sea. It has a big beach line, a lot of hotels, and over there is the port where all of the big cruisers are stopping during the season. Not now at the moment, but usually it is there. This is the port. Can you imagine here one and another one big cruiser lines? They are 3 times taller than the buildings around. But now it's quiet, no one there. Beautiful moment. So now we go past this and go straight on to Rostock port, which is more industrial. Here is the tourist part, over there is the industrial part.
Oh man, finally I'm happy to get out of this ship. It was so hot here on the bottom and smelly. This guy is 78 years old. Man. Wonderful man. We've got a nice conversation. He's riding this 20 years old Harley. So police is stopping randomly. Mostly Swedish cars. So Sweden in the red zone in terms of coronavirus, maybe because of that, I don't know. So all of these zones, red yellow, green, or such a, I don't know what to say. So now I'm coming from Sweden. Sweden is a red zone. No one even asked me about anything. And before that I was in so many countries. So all of this is just pointless, absolutely pointless. Why they do it, I really have no idea. Okay, from here now I have 240 kilometers to Berlin. I will refuel the tank and we'll go. So in about 3 hours time I'll be there. I don't need any maps, any instructions, because I know this road very, very well. I am back in Berlin and my trip is officially over. It was a little above 2 months, like 70 days, 71 days. And I've got around 16,000, a little above 16,000 kilometers. Of course, the highlights of my trip were Bulgaria and Romania. Unfortunately, I cannot visit many of the countries that I plan to visit. But anyway, it is what it is. At least I was able to travel. Many people were not able to do even this. So now I have to focus on my next trip. Thankfully, the bike did everything absolutely well. With a few small technical problems, it survived all the punishment that I asked and come back safe in one piece, which is absolutely great. I love this machine. Yeah, it is not fancy, it is not expensive, it hasn't got most of the extras that the new bikes got, but always works and always bring me whatever I want. This is very, very important for me. All right. Thank you very much for spending so much time on my channel, watching these video episodes, and see you in the next. Ciao.